Amalia later?
In the early 1960s, Amalia took a break and returned after a year. She released her comeback album, Amalia Rodriguez, in 1962. That was her first collaboration with the French composer Alain Ulman. He became her main songwriter and musical producer. He created songs for her that transcended. Do you know what transcended means?
To go beyond?
That's right. His music transcended the conventions of Fado. He created an album with a different kind of Fado, which had aspects of opera. Do you know what opera means?
A big, big musical, then orchestra and costumes and all.
That's right. In that album, called Busto, Amalia sang her own compositions, as well as those by well-known Portuguese composers. Many of the songs like Maria Lisboa and Gaivota became immortal classics, not just in Portugal, but all over the world. And that, ladies and gentlemen, that was the magic of Alain Ulman.